Greetings, rainbow dragons of the new Edenic timeline. It is time to spread your wings and take flight over Pachamama. Today, a powerful day, happy, pink, super full moon in Scorpio, one of the most powerful full moons of the year, pink of the sacred rose of the lineage of Magdalene, Mary Magdalene of the pink rose, with us now, divine feminine Christos of the new earth, activated in every living heart. And know, in this now, the dragon has landed on Turtle Island. We have a pic representing this at the very end of today's transmissions. And also, Merlin's eyes have arrived. He will see clearly very soon and bring great healing to the world. We have many powerful updates and transmissions today. And at the very end, we have a powerful full moon for the pink supermoon prayer and puja ceremony for all of you. So be sure to stick around to the very end of today's transmission. And also the second image for the second half of today's transmissions are from Divine Sistar of the Light, Gypsy Soul Surfer. Now with these powerful, intense energies coming in today, around the full activation of this pink super full moon, on the Schumann resonance, we had a massive blast of white light, 41 hertz magnitude. This is fifth dimensional, higher dimensional plasma waves flowing in, adamantine particles of higher dimensional light flowing into the field. In the last 24 hours, we had many powerful activations, 149 M1.5 or greater earthquakes on Pachamama, most powerful 5.8 Kermadec Islands on the Ring of Fire today. The whole Ring of Fire lit up, activated, fully open. We had a powerful activation, 4.8 in the Sacred Portal, Iran, in the Zagros Mountains, 12 of the Divine Feminine. Japan on the Ring of Fire, 4.3, Dollar Point, 3.2 in California, Southern Alaska, 3.4. New Zealand on the Ring of Fire, just south of the Tropic of Capricorn, we had a 5.2. Vanuatu Ring of Fire, 4.6. Taiwan Ring of Fire, 4.1. Then right in the heart of Lemurian, the center of the ring, the center of the hoop, Hawaii, Ocean View, Hawaii, 3.4. South Sandwich Islands, 5.3. Peru in the Sacred Andes Mountains, home of our sacred condor, Kundalini Pachamama, Peru, 4.812. Divine Goddess Energies, 5.0 Kermadec Islands. Then we had the 5.8, which is also just south of the Tropic of Capricorn. And then another 5.2 following. Kodiak, Alaska, 3.2 off the coast of Oregon, not too far from where the Eagle Condor anchoring the Heros Gamos codes, 4.1 Mentone, Texas, 3.0, 3.2. Another activation in the Emerald Portal, in the heart of Lemuria, the heart chakra, Hawaii, 3.2, and then a 3.6. South Shetland Islands at the trunk of Ganesh, the sacred elephant, 5.0, just north of the Antarctic Circle. Fiji on the Ring of Fire, 4.4, Divine 44. This is the fourth density transitioning into the fifth density, 5D. Very deep, 542, 542 kilometers depth. Then we have multiple activations around the Ring of Fire. Also, in our sacred portal in Africa, in Gabon, this is on the west coast of Africa, just south of the equator. We had two activations, a 4.5 and then a 4.7, another 5.0 Kermadec Islands. New Zealand, 4.6, Papua New Guinea, 5.7, Northern Mariana Islands, 5.0, and then a couple activations with the Atlantean energies of British Virgin Islands, 4.0, 73 kilometers depth, 37 into 73. heaven on earth, Pakistan and the sacred portal, the trinity of sacred mountains, Tian Shan, celestial mountain, Kunlun, center, middle path, Himalayan, the old, divine masculine, Kundalini, with a 4.5101 kilometers depth, the rainbow serpent energy, the rainbow dragons fully activated, of the new Eden, the new Lemuria. Our dragon, Merlin, will be visiting you soon for healing and activations. Now today, from the Sabian symbols, right now the moon at 6 degrees, 7 minutes Scorpio, the sun at 7 degrees, 3 minutes Taurus, 73, the Taurian, the Toroidal, the Soul of Tarsus energy. The current Sabian symbol for the sun, 8 degrees Taurus, a sleigh without snow. Current Sabian symbol for the moon at 7 degrees Scorpio, deep sea divers, from astrologyweekly.com. Today, my sacred condor pull a card for you from the deck Forest of Enchantment Tarot from Lunea Weatherstone, and she pulled a very auspicious card for you, 3 of Boons. In a cozy forest cottage, 3 friends are working together to make a potion. The earth goblin sorts through the mushrooms she gathered. She lives close to the ground and has a keen eye for each growing thing's usefulness. The old witch brews and bottles the potion. She sprinkles a good pinch of enchantment, adding power to the pot as she stirs. The raven writes out the spell instructions and affixes them to the bottles that will be sealed with beeswax. Her expertise comes from poetry and from instinct. These friends are here to remind you that even the smallest task, sorting mushrooms for instance, can contribute to a greater purpose, especially if it is done with a happy and willing heart. Offer your skills to projects that can use them, and don't be shy about asking others to collaborate on your own projects as well. Many hands make light work, as the saying goes, and they also make the work much more fun, meaning at a glance, cooperation, separate parts adding up to a greater whole, fruitful times and happy company. A closer look. The potion ingredients include bracket fungus, Amanita muscaria, boletus, chanterelle, rosemary, mandrake, mint, pin needles, and laughter. And now from Divine Sistar of the Light, S.A. Smith. Schumann resonance begins to spike as we enter the full moon energies. Today has been a wild ride. Working with clients all day, I've been watching their energy fluctuations. It's as if we are moving between stable and explosive energy. It feels massive, like I've never felt before. I was also told by several clients' higher selves today that our energy won't settle until mid-afternoon tomorrow. So be mindful of yourself as we go through these over the next 18 or so hours. Big ascension symptoms that may be felt are full root chakra upgrades, heart chakra, ears ringing, energy buzzing in your system. Your electronics may start disconnecting or working strange around you. Nausea, extreme hunger, fatigue, random pains, hearing odd sounds others don't hear. Hydrate, rest, and just be. Allow it all to flow for you and through you. Much love and light. Energies intensify in front of the full moon. You are surrounded by huge, high vibrational energies overnight, rushing in through our magnetosphere, down through the atmosphere to you. These energies will intensify through the day today, preparing you for the biggest energetic full moon of the year. This full moon will bring upgrade energies unlike anything that we've experienced on this planet so far. It's all about timing and frequency. Where you are on your path will determine how you feel any and all of these energies. You may be in a rest phase where your system just went through a large upgrade and isn't ready for these. If that's the case, you can just relax and enjoy. You may not receive these energies today, but once your system is ready, they'll be there waiting to upgrade you again. Or you might be in a receiving phase, your system paused and waiting for all these over the next 24 hours. If that's the case, get ready to ride the waves of these energies. They will be intense and bring in major upgrades to your system. Once you experience them, it will take 3 days to transmute the energy through your system. On the other side of that experience will be new knowings, understandings, or abilities. It is different with everyone, because it is as unique to you as these energies are to all of us. However you experience the next 24 to 48 hours is exactly how you are meant to experience them. You are an amazing being of light and love. Shine it out. This is all part of your ascension journey. From agirlintheuniverse.com. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Laura Pleiadian. Full supermoon, pink moon, April 26, 27, 2021, in Scorpio. The challenge. The supermoon, pink moon, here we go. For many, this is more dramatic than a usual full moon and will take place in the evening of the 26th. For many, this will occur on the 27th, depending on your time zone. It will take place on Tuesday, the 27th, 2021, at 12:33 a.m. ADT. Calculate your time zone from this. Are you up for the challenge? All full moons are intense, but this one specifically will be more potent for most, especially those not fully focused and grounded in moment-to-moment awareness and the constant flow of harmony through the heart. This is all about harmony, challenge to overcome disharmony, taking each experience as it comes up into the state of pure harmony. When you are in harmony, you are in the coherent wave of constant aware connection with all that is. As plasma is so much the entire connecting force and the body a stopping point of that plasma, the more you are fully aligned, the more you become aware of each moment as the creative force within you, to create in this, immersed in universe and beyond connection. There is no stopping place or edge of this universe, it is limitless. This harmony impacts your DNA in a far greater way than the same old, victim consciousness that attempts to manipulate and change things out there. This is backwards to how it works. Watch carefully, observe the non-awareness of the mental chatter that is so familiarly yours. All I can say is the mastery of form is what I am referring to here for those that can possibly hear. Not many are fully awake, immersed in this pattern of harmony. Check your beliefs about time and good and bad, then you will tap into a minuscule awareness of what this is about. The full moon, supermoon, pink moon is opposite Uranus, square Saturn, and trine Mars. All frequencies impact your energy uniquely. What is triggered or not is unique to your blueprint. The blueprint itself and your DNA responds to the information you are giving it. Negative, same old, create more of that. Fear begets more of. Do not be fooled. Fear is worry, is anxiety, is disease, is disharmony. Constant harmony is the mastery of form. These aspects of the full moon may trigger specific things in your consciousness that you are acting unaware of. The challenge then is to observe and accept what comes up within you. As the truth is, there is no out there creating your reality. Isn't it the moment yet for you to let go of victim consciousness and a time-based reality? Things are changing. Get with the new program. The program is harmony. It is the only thing that will take you through what is about to take place moment to moment. Entering your heart, accepting your creating your reality, is part and parcel of the new divine human being that has mastered form and lives as the divine creator of form. In this, we activate you now in love from the new divinehumanity.com. And today from Sparks of Divine Light Healing, we are really feeling tonight's Scorpio full moon as it's a super moon. Tonight's pink moon is the second largest moon of the year. We are instant manifesting with these energies. Many of you are also feeling the increase in energies. May will be a big month energetically, so we are preparing. Look at today's Scorpio full moon as bringing a cleanse. It's bringing up what needs to be released. That's the old you. Old programs and patterns are being highlighted. A lot of these came from many generations ago. Family lessons needing to be cleared through you. Releases the old fully. There's a lot of work going on with the root chakra right now. This full moon is extra powerful for magic. It's bringing a lot of spirit messages with it. These energies are also preparing to take us into Beltane, which is May 1st, and the 5-5 portal. Tonight's full moon is the last full moon before we kick off next month's eclipse season. That's why we are feeling it so much. Eclipse season runs from May 13th through June 19th. We have a Sagittarius total lunar eclipse May 26th. This is the first total lunar eclipse we have had in almost 2.5 years. This is also a supermoon and a blood moon. When this eclipse occurs, we're going to get an amazing view of the Milky Way. We have a Gemini solar eclipse June 10th. An eclipse season lasts 35 days, but we will feel the effects for the next 18-month cycle. Expect a ton of Pleiadian energies over the next month. That means any starseeds are really being activated right now. From sparksofdivinelighthealing.com and from Divine Sistar of the Light, Karen Lithica. Fifth dimensional color expansion. As your physical form adjusts, as your eyes awaken to higher dimensional abilities, know the rainbow light codes are expanding as your eyes integrate multidimensional expansion, a new way to view color as you integrate the higher intelligence of color. Understand the color spectrum language is a new energetic format to interpret. It simply requires your multidimensional light field to absorb the higher light codes. To move through to your physical conscious form, as your world upgrades, so does every light being. Connect to colors and absorb within your eyes, hands, feel your light body integrating. A whole new multidimensional world is fast approaching. Know you are doing wonderfully well, sending waves of cosmic love, the Arcturians and Karen Lithica, from KarenLithica.com. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Carolyn, Servant of Yahweh. Happy Scorpio full supermoon. Today's energies are bringing more physical endings to all karmic marriage contracts through all lifetimes. Destiny is moving us into our new cycle of alchemical creator unions of sacred marriages. This is divine timing that is reflecting in our physical reality and lifestyle. Nothing can stop this. We are being shown how to align completely into this new unknown cycle. The divine is cutting the cords to end karmic attachments to the energy body and chakra system. Contracts that have been blocking your energy expansion are over. Your wings are expanded. Truth supersedes all opponents. You are fully supported by the divine. Take action and fly. You have already manifested this new cycle of life, love, and union. The contracts have been cut from the past. You have already succeeded in your purification and growth. All that is needed to complete your manifestations is taking physical action. Father trauma and distorted masculine wounding are transmuting from the mind, skull, brain, nervous system, and chakra body. External distorted masculine behaviors may challenge you today. Internal distorted masculine behaviors are leaving the system, which may feel like buzzing, vibrating, and electricity leaving the flesh. You are ready, logical, strong, independent, and energized to make any necessary changes to remove these frequencies, behaviors, and environments. Collectively, the divine masculine Christ are waking up to the truth. Brainwashing and lust spells that kept the masculine in the distorted raw template of temptation, money, power, and war have been broken today. There's no going backwards. The Most High is putting His sword of truth in our hands today to continue this completion of our efforts on earth, as above, so below. Thank you, warriors of Yahweh. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. From Carolyn Kundalini Twin Flames. And today from a gift from Gaia. We are continuing on from yesterday with C-class flares and another wave from the solar storm at G1 level, moderate. All this extra light, plus the light of the incoming full moon, will of course be shifting the balances within. The more density we hold, the more disrupted our systems and therefore our physical reality experience starts to form with disruption. Aligning with the harmonic flow naturally places us in a softer, more earth rhythmic state, a little like how we slow down when it's a scorching hot day, we seek shade, or if it's a freezing cold day, we would seek shelter and warmth. The solar winds are no different. The experience is disorienting due to the growth hormone activation. Our magnetic fields are disrupted and we receive choices and opportunities to change course or direction. These changes are most often misunderstood as suffering, which technically doesn't exist once light language is understood. To surf these energies, we unplug. We feel deep into self and by doing so, we get to observe more blind addictions in the form of attachments to the reality itself. And this enables the freedom of choice, the opportunity to rise in peace, health, and therefore abundance too. Expanding the field in peace, anchoring the baseline frequency can and will only bring miraculous healing coupled with the experience of a collapsing time and space. All expands and in doing so sheds enough light to see any lingering dense spots to smarten up. Light is wisdom, and is found in the central space of silence, happiest of serfs to you. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Sarah Hayes, super full moon in Scorpio, honoring the intensity of your being, the love of power over the power of love, sweeping changes that run deep. On April 26th, 27th, we have the powerful and potent super full moon at 7 degrees of Scorpio. This is the second super full moon of four that will happen in 2021. This one is sure to be a doozy, so be prepared. Full moons are already highly emotional and bring our feelings to the surface to be cleansed and released. They also represent endings, completions, and manifestations. Being that this is a super moon, which is much brighter and more visible than a regular full moon, will intensify these emotions even greater. Scorpio, the eighth zodiac sign, deals with shared resources, power, transformation, and sexuality. The super full moon in Scorpio is here to bring up unresolved and deeply psychological issues to the surface to be purged and released. An intense and cathartic energy of emotions are sure to be felt and experienced by many. Scorpio as a sign also deals with death and at the same time resurrection. This sign is the most understood of all the 12 signs. Scorpio energy goes where no mere mortal can go and wants the whole truth, no silver lining, and to get to the bottom of any problem. This is often why the sign of Scorpio is so feared, but also why they are so respected. It takes guts to face issues head on and to have the resolve and grit to come back from those depths of feelings with a renewed strength and sense of purpose. The super full moon in Scorpio will want you to face the skeletons within your own closet and will reveal the true intentions of others. Many secrets from the past could be brought up during the next 2 weeks. These could have to do with how others have misused or manipulated their power and control. These truths could be quite dark, but the lesson of this powerful full moon will be around making space for the darker aspects of life and instead of running or hiding from them, confronting them with humility. This is where the true power and courage of Scorpio energy lies. Confrontation in all forms is their speciality. The darkness of life is just as natural as the light. In fact, one cannot exist without the presence of the other. This super full moon in the Scorpion's Den will ask us to be brave and be willing to look our fear straight in the face once and for all. No more denying, no more putting it under the rug, no more repression. Major and profound healing of these inner wounds is what is possible within this next lunar cycle. If you are willing to be honest with yourself, this full moon will hold the keys to your soul being cleansed on a deep cellular level, a washing away of the past ways of being that were connected to fear or rejection could be one possible manifestation. This Scorpio super full moon won't be kind to those not willing to confront their stuff. Expect the unexpected and be ready to dive deep. Enlightenment and trust is what this full moon will bring forth for those willing to do the work. One of the main aspects that the Scorpio full moon will make with her other planetary brothers and sisters will be a tense opposition, 180-degree aspect to Uranus, the planet of change, curveballs, and freedom. The super full moon in Scorpio opposing Uranus and Taurus will lead us to some interesting and unexpected emotions that might come up from nowhere. The Taurus-Scorpio axis in astrology deals with value of myself versus value of others. A sudden awakening to how we have been giving away our own power could be revealed. Surprises of all kinds around money and resources also another manifestation of this aspect. Some could hit the jackpot, while others could experience a sudden blow to their resources. However it plays out, you won't see it coming. Being present and aware is the best way to deal with Uranus's opposition to the full moon. The Scorpio super full moon is here to show you that you can face the darker aspects of life with grace and compassion. Truly, there is no other way out but through. There is an acknowledgement with this potent full moon of things, people, and values that we need to let go of. This might at first seem super scary, but truth be told, we as humans are pretty good at release and allowance. This last year has taught us the meaning of being shaken to the core and still finding the strength and willpower to rise once again. Sometimes things need to die to make room for fresh energy. This is the natural cycle of life. The Scorpio super full moon wants you to honor the process of letting go with resiliency and softness. No need to be harsh or cruel with yourself. This is a time to end such suffering and to be your own best friend. The Scorpio super full moon is here to bring issues of power and control up to the surface to be dealt with. Have you faced your darkest fears with reverence and kindness, and to remind you, just like the phoenix rising from the ashes, you too can remake and transform yourself. It is your superpower and your natural birthright. From AstroMama.com. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Adrian Elise. Gaia Daily, April 26th through 30th. Flood of Truth. There is some potent but beautiful astrology happening around today's full moon in Scorpio. We are being asked to be present and stand as witness for this epic moment in history. The tide is about to turn. The water is with us as this full moon trines up with Mars at 1 degree Cancer as it becomes full. Scorpio desires depth and meaning. Is it time for the flood of truth, humanity? The energy has been super activating with Mercury and Venus hanging out with Uranus and Taurus for the last few days. Everything is pointing to a revolution in wealth, which first requires we are discovering a revolution of self-worth. It is time to come out of the shadows of the abusive relationship humanity has been in with its controllers. With Saturn, Chiron, Uranus, and the North Node all lining up to 10 to 12 degrees, we are being shown the way out of the lower matrix energies. Chiron is telling us that our wealth and self-worth really come down to owning our life force energy. This is our own divine power accessible to all right inside. It is our immune system and potency in full expression. We have been giving away this power to lower energies, not realizing it was ours in the first place. Saturn is in trine to the North Node, saying truth and empowerment and overcoming division are the new guidelines that can move us into the new age. Saturn is also in sextile relationships to Chiron and Aries, which is telling us our truth is our life force, and therefore we cannot truly live unless we are truly free. Truth equals freedom equals life force is our divine birthright. From AdrianElise.com. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Leah Whitehorse, Lua Astrology. Full moon in Scorpio, Pluto in Capricorn, stations retrograde. We reach an emotional high tide as the pink supermoon stirs the deep waters of the unconscious. Ruler Pluto is stationing, adding weight so that we sink further down to explore what lies beneath. Co-ruler Mars is still out of bounds, so it may feel like anything could happen. Amidst this, the moon also triggers the Saturn-Uranus square, pulling us between restriction and freedom, old and new. The moon in Scorpio asks that we eradicate what is dead and gone, what no longer works, but we're holding on, afraid, scared of what will replace the void ahead. To thrive, it is necessary to periodically purge, let go. The Sabian symbol of this full moon is a calm lake bathed in the moonlight. Close your eyes and imagine the scene, the glittering lake, a quiet hoot of an owl, a fox yip, a soft breeze. This is the place of the wild unknown, secrets and mysteries yet to be revealed. Underneath life's complexities and emotional storms lies a deep and abiding peace. Trust this place, trust life, trust yourself. From LeahWhitehorse.com. Today from the Dzogchen Times. Kin 133, Red Electric Skywalker. Electric is the name for the number 3, and its keywords are activate, service, and bond. This is the third day of the blue monkey wave spell. Certainly monkey can be tricky, especially the first few days as we are positioned right in the middle of the two portal day columns. This is a powerful but intense time, and it won't let up until we get to the red spectral dragon in 8 days' time. However, electric is always a fun number regardless of which wave spell it occurs. So much energy comes in very handy if you make use of it. Today is Red Skywalker, which represents space, wakefulness, and explore. The Skywalker loves to go on adventures, and this curiosity is quite catching. Follow the Pied Piper today or go on a magical mystery tour. As it is an electric day, today is perfect for activating an adventure and also expanding your mind. Think outside the box today and be a little daring. It doesn't hurt sometimes to surprise yourself. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio, 1212 coming in, the third portal opened to my sacred condor. Red Electric Skywalker, Kin 133, 26 April 2021, activating infinite bliss. 26 4 2021 equal 8 4 4 1 equal 8 8 1 equal 8 9 equals 17 equal 8. 26 Empowerment through compassion. 4 Form structure foundation earth. 9 Destiny service humanity grace. Endings 17 Immortality legacy. 8 Infinity eternity abundance source flow. Kin 133 equals 7, mystic magic, spiritual solitude. A very potently expansive day, full throttle, maximum acceleration to activate heaven on earth. Day 3 in the blue monkey wave spell of magic, joy, bliss, play, merriment, and a return to innocence. Today we activate the joy and bliss. This is best expressed through exploring the magic that lies dormant within us and around us. Using the electric tone to ignite the spark to create more magic, joy, and bliss in our lives. Tone of creation. Today's tone is electric. This is pure creative genius energy, Tesla power. The electric tone coupled with the Skywalker, Blue Monkey, and Magic 7 and 8-8 source codes today adds up to another electrically charged rocket-fueled day. Electric is tone number 3 in the tone of creation. It is the first of the three emotional realm tones. Its focus is on the being of service to others through the action of bonding, that is coming together with others to co-create and be of service. This desire is amplified today through the 17-8 legacy code. Electric energy provides the ignition or spark for your manifestation. It is a current that needs to keep moving and flowing, transmitting energy. It also adds power to anything you are creating today. An extra electrical boost to draw upon. The power of three is derived from two units merging and creating the third, more powerful entity. This action duplicates the essence of bonding and service that the electric tone provides. Today we bond together through the power of magic to ignite joy and bliss, lifting the vibe of our entire planet. Note, electric energy is very volatile and combustible, which can lead to short-fused interactions today, particularly with the cheeky monkey energies, especially as it is an emotional realm tone. Be aware that people may be easily triggered on these days. Remember to direct this energy into creative and inventive projects so you can fully utilize the power available to light up our world. Today is a great day for manifesting magic and fueling our dreams and desires. To create a bliss-filled, beautiful life of constant flowing joy, a life we all truly deserve, the collective dream of abundance for all beings. So, beloved star blossoms, go forth and ignite the magic, so that it may grow and expand and continually grant all your wishes. Today's questions are, how can I activate more magic, joy, and bliss as I explore greater potentials for my creative expression through divine service? How can we build together a new magical foundation for peace, joy, and abundance for New Earth? Planetary service, activating heaven on Earth. A great day to visualize the golden gates of Source opening wide and sending forth massively expansive golden rainbow codes, flooding onto our planet and over all the tribes of our planetary kin. Bonding in divine service to Nova Gaia, manifesting our beautiful utopian world. Today's code is absolutely brilliant for all kin to bond together in unison to activate the dream that the awakened ones are holding for the whole community. Visualize all beings safe and protected from harm, enfolded in divine love and light so we can successfully activate the new earth dream. May peace and liberty prevail on planet Earth. Amen. An absolutely brilliant day to swim, meditate with the dolphins, play with children and our animals, and activate your bliss genes. Divine blessings for the most expansive, bliss-filled day. En la kek a la kin, Christina White, Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66. Kin 133, Red Electric Skywalker. The mantra, the code for today is, I activate in order to explore. Bonding wakefulness, I seal the output of space. With the electric tone of service, I am guided by the power of navigation. And on this powerful day, navigators of the new earth energies, let us know in the comments below what you're experiencing, what you're feeling, your dreams, your visions, and your synchronicities. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below and the little bell to get notifications on future updates. And as always, we have a link in the description below to the transcriptions of today's transmissions. We archive these on our website, primedisclosure.com. I'd like to also take the time to thank everyone for supporting us and our work and mission. We rely on our pledges on Patreon and our donations for our daily living expenses. So if you'd like to support our work and help contribute to allow us to continue doing this work and bringing these transmissions to the world daily, you can make a pledge on patreon.com/primedisclosure. If you'd like to make a one-time donation, you can do so at eaglelovecondor.com. Now, I'd like to also take the time to thank everyone supporting my Sacred Condors business on Etsy.com. Thank you, Divine Brostar of the Light, Pat Shemery, for purchasing more beautiful art from my Sacred Condor. And also thank you, Divine Sister of the Light, Jess Lunacy, for your purchase today. We appreciate you, and these beautiful works of art are coming to you with the Divine Union Codes, the Hieros Gamos, the Divine Abundance, Divine Freedom, made by the hands of my Sacred Queen, Goddess of the New Earth. She also has a sale going on all the items, 20% out, for Mother's Day until May 11th, so you can support her at lunagoddessart.com. Now we're going to end today's transmissions with three powerful activations and codes, one from our Divine Pleiadian Brostars and Sistars of the Light, Divine Decree from Divine Sistar Sandra Walter, and the Sacred Puja Ceremony of the Full Moon from Archangelic Calendar. So we start with the Pleiadians transmission. Pleiades 1 messages, April 26, 2021. P1 calling Terrans for origins recognition, attention for calls and PVSC-SDE. Expanding forces keep coming. Completion of cycles in progress. Devic restorations in progress. Christic harmonization increases. Enchanted world show. MID pursuits decrease as divine soul expands. Attention, plus, plus, plus. Dabaros AFR, support of projector for illumination started, 72% non-regressive. Plus, plus, plus. Dabaros AFR, line illumination in progress, 71% non-regressive. The light celebrates. Plus, plus, plus. Dabaros AFR, higher reverberation, 71% non-regressive, the light celebrates. Silver dragons in support and reverberation, 82% non-regressive. OSECCT, Pleiadian performances and reverberations in progress, 72% non-regressive. Attention, FDH, support for special projector started, 62% non-regressive. Sacred redirects in progress. Soul transitions continue. Temporarily end of transmission. Pleiades 1. Potentiating shamanic inheritances. DisclosureNews.it. And from Divine Sister of the Light, Sandra Walters. Divine Decree. I call in through and around me the diamond shining purity of divine love from the heart of creation. I open myself as a pure conduit of this divine activity of ascension, from ascensionpath.com. And now a powerful super pink full moon in Scorpio, the children's puja. Specific points of interest from the macro goddess collective. Just as the stormy dark water Scorpio super full moon pulls with extra force at the tides of our lovely Gaia Ma's body of water, so too will we feel the intense pull of this moon on our emotional body's waves and currents. There is also a stellium of cosmic forces opposing the Scorpio moon and earthy Taurus, which impacts all that pertains to our physical vessels, where these aspects intersect shall be most elucidated. In addition to the superposition of the full moon, there are also other planetary aspects boosting the power of release work. Set healing intentions for the inner child, as the emotional body is extraordinarily active and wounds are likely to have a hair trigger. When we feel triggered, we have an open invitation to investigate and transmute the core root of the pain. Celestial frequencies highly supportive of working through any kinds of physical body-related traumas, particularly for those who have been working on these ordeals. Difficult aspects of essential relationships, family, life partner, significant others, close friendships, are up front for necessary alchemy and disillusions. Practical and material matters in the macro setting on Earth that has been swept under the proverbial rug are no longer able to be ignored, leading to eventual complete large-scale reorganization. Stark contrast between polarized forces, duality dramas, highlighted, leading to increased personal energy required to maintain a steady stream of peace, joy, love, vibration. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the east to bring forth the highest and most profound winds of healing. This breeze is one of the highest and most profound aspects of existence, and is to be given directly to the beautiful children of the space and time. Send pink breeze, light blue breeze, and white breeze to bless the children of the earth. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the southeast, and evoke the highest form of protection to engulf all children. Place a rainbow shield around all children of earth. This shield originates from our central sun. I place my mind, body, and divine spirit to the south to summon transmutational flames to change the trajectory for all those who do not have children's best interests at heart. Engulf the earth in the following flames: black, violet, indigo, light blue, white, and rainbow. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the southwest to cleanse the earth of malevolent impulses with the power of interdimensional fire. Send the earth the following flames: white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, and rainbow. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the west to remove all obstacles regarding the well-being of children. Let all their needs be met. Let no child be hungry, cold, or afraid ever again. Summon the following red and green modalities to earth: breeze, plasma, light, crystalline lights, thundering light to the children of the earth. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the northwest to summon forth the cleansing rain of light. In this sacred rain, we bring blessings to this generation and the many others to come. Aho, this great generation has arrived. Please be sure to pay special attention to the most gentle among us, the children, the animals, the plants, and the trees. Summon cleansing rain of light, gently washing over yourself, your loved ones, and all life on earth in the following colors: white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, and rainbow. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the north as we endow the children of the earth with the light of our origins. We ask the archangels for assistance with its divine blessing as we imbue all children with innate protection. Summon the following to the children of earth: Archangel Michael, Archangel Raphael, Archangel Gabriel, Archangel Och, Archangel Ia, Archangel Faith, Archangel Clare, and Archangel Orion. Then engulf the children in the following ray lights: white ray, blue ray, yellow ray, pink ray, green ray, ruby ray, and violet ray. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to the northeast to bless all things of Gaia, the wind, the sun, the clouds, the sky, and all things that we may experience on this earth. We embrace the guidance and protection from our divine mother. We imbue the children with her motherly essence. Radiate love to all the world via Gaia. Access Gaia's heart chakra by linking yours with hers and send blessings to all of the earth, paying particular attention to the children. Send this love in the form of dense white light or anything else that calls you. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit to all the unnamed directions to create a sacred space of love within this blessing, to imbue the children we hold near and dear to our hearts with Source's gifts. We bless you with the deepest love and the highest aspects of our divine selves. Envision yourself as a child and the other children of your choosing, standing in front of Archangel Metatron. Envision Archangel Metatron knighting the children in the deepest love and most profound lights of infinitely expanding Creator Source. Then envision yourself as a youth doing the same. I face my mind, body, and divine spirit within, to see that all of our physical reality is a child of infinitely expanding Creator Source. And now meditate, and please speak the following aloud as you come out of meditation. Metaquiosin, 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 Aho, from the archangelicalendar.com. So thank you for joining us today, beloved beings of light. Have a beautiful and blessed pink, full supermoon in Scorpio. Keep walking your sacred path with heart. And always remember, I am the way, the truth, and the light. I am the resurrection and the life. I am that I am. I am. And now, rise up and make it the best day ever. The eagle and the condor love you all. Namaste.